Hi guys, Aris, Hardware Busters International. Today we have two all-in-ones by First Player, which are impossible to get if you don't live in Asia. That said, I hope that First Player will be able to find some distributors in US and Europe. Anyway, MT360 and MT240 Mothra. We have full RGB, ARGB, addressable RGB to be more specific, on the block, tubes and the cooling fans. It is very nice, actually, especially in the white version of the MT360 Mothra. Well, material, copper for the block, aluminum for the radiator. Mothras come in two flavors, 360mm radiator and 240mm. The block and pump combo is not large, but the block has a large enough base. Nonetheless, it doesn't support huge CPU heatsinks, including AMD's Threadripper CPUs. Tubing length and diameter, 400 to 410 millimeters and 19 millimeter width. Yeah, the diameter is increased because the tubes include ARGB lighting. Cooling fans. We have three or two HDB hydraulic dynamic bearing, PWM controlled fans, 120mm diameter, 200-300 RPM maximum. Yeah, that's quite high for all-in-one. And according to the manufacturer, only 38 dBA noise. Yeah, I doubt about that, but we will see. Socket compatibility, Intel and AMD, all popular sockets. Price, the best part, I had to convert the prices from the Asian market since they are not available in Europe or the US. Anyway, MT240, 83 euros or 95 USD, and the MT360, 111 euros or 126 USD. These prices are very good, but as I see it, there is no way, especially in the US market, if these products, if ever become available, to come at such low price tags. Availability, for the moment, only in Southeast Asia and China. You will have to wait till these guys find any distributor in other regions. Who it refers to? Enthusiast users who like RGB lighting. What is included in the box? Mounting hardware for all popular Intel and AMD sockets, including Intel's HCDT systems, but not AMD's TR4 platforms. Two and three-way PWM splitter cable for the fans, depending on the all-in-one model. In the box, you will also find the thermal paste tube and Intel backplate, along with some extra case screws to mount the radiator directly on the chassis. For the AMD systems, you use the stock backplate, which is already installed on your mainboard, and there is also an ARGB power line. Build quality and external design. The build quality is fine given the price tag. The major con looks to be the tubes, which are not flexible and look like they will break if you try to bend them a lot. The fans mention HDB in the specs, which is the best type of bearing, but I am not sure that their quality is as high without testing the coolers for prolonged periods under extreme conditions, and unfortunately this is something not possible in terms of review. Nonetheless, I have to repeat that for this price tag, both products look fine. Installation. As I have mentioned already, for AMD systems you use the existing backplate. For Intel systems you use the provided backplate, so you have to have access to the mainboard's soldered side. All in all, the installation is not that tough. Please take a look at the rest of the installation video to check for yourself. Another note that I have to make here is that the brackets through which the block is installed on the socket attach to the block through a set of screws that go through a plastic piece. If the latter breaks, say goodbye to the cooler. This happened to me, not in this product, but with a Cooler Master AML360R, and I had to throw away an expensive all-in-one because of this failure. I couldn't find a replacement part, you see. Testing methodology. I use a fully automated, custom-made CPU cooled testing station that can apply any load from 1 watt up to 500 watt. At the same time, the fan speed can change automatically, so many test scenarios can be applied without having to supervise the whole procedure, which can last for several hours. Using a simulated load has several advantages, with the most important being that you don't have to rely on a specific CPU, which will eventually get outdated. On top of that, no CPU can apply precisely the same load level for a prolonged period. There are always power spikes and drops, which affect, of course, the final result. By using now an electronic loader, you can apply precisely the thermal load you want. And besides being more accurate, the whole testing procedure is easier too. Finally, I only take into account the delta differences between the CPU's block and the ambient temperature in our lab where the test system is installed. And let's go to performance. Thermal performance, full fan speed. Very good performance by both coolers with 400 watt and 500 watt loads, taking the lead from the much more expensive Corsair H150i Elite Capilix. Nonetheless, the full fan speed comparison doesn't say the whole story because it doesn't take into account noise output. Thermal performance, 35 dBA. Okay, with 35 dBA fan noise output by all contenders, the big Mothra retains its third place, but the smaller one drops in the second before the end place. That said, it is very close to the Kraken X63, which is among the best 280mm all-in-ones. The Mothra MT240 has the smallest radiator among all coolers in this graph, and still it manages to keep up very well. Noise output, fan speed percentage and RPM. The maximum speed of the fans is 2300 RPM. The output noise is far away, as you can see, from the provided specs. These fans are noisy at full speed, very noisy. Full fan speed, both first player coolers, as I've already said, are noisy, but the fans support PWM control, so you can easily adjust their speed and noise. Noise output with the fan spinning at 70%. The first player coolers still are in the top places of this chart, which is not good, of course. Time to steady state. The time required to reach a steady state is quite long for both coolers, which looks to be a good sign for all-in-ones. For air coolers, it is the other way around. Relative performance, full fan speed, jalapeno. Overall performance at full fan speed is good for the 360mm Mothra and exceptional for its smaller sibling. Performance per dBA at full fan speed, it is not good for both coolers since they are super noisy at full fan speed, so this was expected. Relative performance 35 dBA on jalapeno. The big Mothra meets the competition while the smaller model performs decently here. Performance per dollar, full fan speed. The prices in Asia's market where these products are only available for the moment are very good. If they keep the same prices in Europe and the States, which I doubt once they become available there, first player will have two strong all-in-ones in each arsenal. Two very strong products in this category. Bottom line, the biggest downside of the Mothra coolers is the limited availability. Till first player finds distributors in the US and Europe, there is no way to get your hands on this product. Keeping the same low prices in the US market will be tough with the import fees, and the same goes, of course, for Europe. The performance is good for both coolers, but noise output is high if you run the fans at full speed. Thanks to the PWM control, though, you can easily configure fan speed to your taste. ARGB lighting, even on the cooling tubes, is a nice extra feature, but it makes the tubes less flexible and bulky. Still, it looks great, and you can see that. First player manages to deliver good products at affordable prices, and the Mothra all-in-ones are a fine example of this. I'm looking forward to reviewing more products from this brand. Both all-in-ones, PSUs, if they have any chassis, I know. Pros, good performance, low price, in the Asia market at least, very good GPU and RAM clearance, high enough build quality, ARGB lighting on block, fans and tubes, easy installation, rich enough bundle. Cons, limited availability and noisy, very noisy at full speed. another review by Hardware Busters International. Please subscribe to our channel for more. Also, leave a comment. And if you have any questions, we also have a Discord server where you can find us almost 24/7. And we also have a Patreon page if you want to support us, since most samples that you see in this channel are bought by us. Till the next review, bye bye.